quickly want to pull out some of the more obvious elements of this story. Academy Award winner, Best Film, 1963. So let's go over basic story architecture first so we know what we're doing. When you first start writing and filmmaking, you have a linear perspective in that sense. Pretty soon you realize that both the beginning and the ending are the same, which is why we demonstrate story structure via a loop. We identify the classic beginning as a state of perfection, which is lost, becomes a state of imperfection, and the process of returning to it is undergone. We can start there or somewhere in the lost phase. If we do that, then the events there tend to be referenced at later stages. Most stories, such as this one, end with some form of state of perfection, liberation, equilibrium, catharsis, however you want to term it. If you don't like that, if you want to end with imperfection or some combination, that's irrelevant. The process is always the same. So you're always going to have transformation, change, metamorphosis, transmogrification, psychological journey, you're always going to have physical journey, and you're always moving through new worlds, which really are physical manifestations of new psychological states and new versions of the self. Working your way around the cycle involves jumping through lots of hoops. Each hoop has its own set of sub-stages, which in essence are functions which may be performed, messages which may be communicated. They tell you what tangibles or intangibles you're going in there to acquire, how to construct those sequences. So for example, if that's the ordinary world, we know it's made up of repression, protection, fear of exit, etc. So those sub-stages show you how to construct those sequences. From another point of view, you have a range of options that are consistently executed to push yourself and your hero or archetypes around the cycle. The journey itself is a metaphor for a number of things: maturity, readiness, awakening, etc. When you are here, you have none of those. You are unable to return and right the wrong. So you have to go forward, you have to grow, learn, mature, gain capacities in order to be able to become ready to return. So that is basic story architecture. It's the fundamental framework that all successful stories are based upon, including all Academy Award winner best films. Now, let's get rid of all that. And let's draw another loop so we know now there's much more behind that than a simple circle represents. So the state of perfection, in essence, is lost. We've got an illegitimate birth. So we see parallels here with the Jesus story, Moses, Superman, etc. In other words, a separation from the original world and a perfect state from the original parent. We have a supernatural aid, in other words, a surrogate parent, so that is Squire Allworthy. And that takes us around to our imperfect or lost state, in essence an ordinary world, ordinary state. So this is the point where the hero is on the cusp of maturity and ready to embark on the journey. So there's various gaps opening up there, so it's a deficient state, a devolved state, so our friend, the poacher, is exiled. And then in essence we have the call to adventure, which is Molly telling or asking Tom to get her a job as a maid, which really pulls him out or pushes him out to meet Sophie Weston. Standard functions there all the way until we get to the first threshold, which is what we're aiming for, and we're thrust there. So Sophie's horse bolts and Tom races after her, and that really drags us in to that phase. We've got containment symbolism, so Tom's arm is broken, and we remain in that state until we develop the capacity to exit it, until we pull out the tangibles or intangibles that we acquire. And in this case, what we want to pull out is our romantic challenge. So this is the romantic sequence where Tom and Sophie, in essence, fall in love. Physical separation, the fight with the cousin or the brother or whatever relative he is, and we're thrown out of the house. We have a supernatural aid that rescues us, so that is Squire Weston. But then, realizing that Tom has eyes for his daughter, he's exiled further and pushed onto the road of trials. There we have death symbolism, detachment functions, so the fight with the soldier, and then being knocked out, so everybody thinking that Tom is dead, which symbolizes death of the older state and older self. Detachment function, we're losing the 500 pounds, remember, given to us by our ordinary self attachment, so again, indicative of losing the older state. meeting our oracle, supernatural aid, so rescuing the female, which in essence leads us into the bedroom scene, and Sophie turns up, loses her pocketbook, and Tom finds it. So that then brings us, or starts, the beginning of the return. Near-death experience, being held up, rebirth, finding our father, atonement, in essence the world that Mrs. Fitzpatrick brings us into, apotheosis, her money, exiles us from the older state of poverty into the new state of wealth. So he's dressed as a squire, as a squire's son should be, dressed really well now, so we see transformation there, and Boone really meeting Sophie Weston in this new moneyed state as this new self. All the way around, Dastardly Deed, in essence, is the fight, which takes us to the final conflict, where we've got repression, so we're held captive, and in essence what we have is a letting go. So Squire Weston realizes that Tom is an heir, so we let go of the earlier limitations which were established here, and then Squire Weston himself rescues Tom, and our state of perfection is achieved by our hero, or hero and heroine, our prince and our princess, kissing and in essence walking off into the sunset. So that's the final sequence where Tom and Sophie kiss arm in arm. So a very basic deconstruction of that story. If you want a detailed deconstruction, you can order it off the website, but once again just showing you that this story follows this pattern of journey, transformation, movement through new worlds and states, which is the fundamental framework that all these successful stories follow. And you can purchase the 2,000 plus stage of journey, transformation, movement through new worlds and states, the whole process, from our website.